Hi, this is Josiah Failauer bringing you a Research Bite. And if you want this Research Bite in American Sign Language, look at the show notes below and click on the link for the ASL version, and you can get this entire description in American Sign Language. So, when interpreting from sign language into English or English into sign language, how much time should the interpreter allow for processing? There's a term called lag time. However, more currently, we're using the term processing time. Basically, processing time can be understood as the time it takes for information to be received, processed, and then delivered from a source language, which is the language it's coming from, into the target language, which is the language that it's going into. This is called processing time, or an older term for this is lag time. The article we're looking at today is titled Effects of Lag Time on Interpreter Errors. This research was done by the late Dr. Dennis Coakley. This research was originally published in 1986 in Sign Language Studies, and then the research was then published again in 2014, this time by Gallaudet University Press, this time published for the National Consortium of Interpreter Education Centers, otherwise known as the NCIEC. The research itself was done in 1983. This study by Dr. Coakley is a quantitative study. It makes a causal comparative relationship between lag time and errors. Basically, how does lag time impact interpreting errors? Another term he uses in the study is miscues to define errors. What Dr. Coakley did is he recorded four conference interpreters working from English into ASL, and they analyzed a total of 8 minutes for each sign language interpreter. They then transcribed the spoken English of the presentation as well as the interpreter's interpretation, which was done in ASL, and both were recorded and then compared, including timestamps. This is how Dr. Coakley was able to determine when the original message was uttered and when the interpretation was delivered. Dr. Coakley then recorded the lag time for the interpretation, the gap between the utterance originally and when it was delivered in American Sign Language. There was then a process of careful analysis of the interpretation to look for miscues, which is the term Dr. Coakley was using to describe errors in interpreting. These types of errors would be things like omissions, additions, substitutions, intrusions, and anomalies, which basically comprise most categories of errors when one is doing interpreting work. And here's what you need to know about this article. Dr. Coakley found that interpreters with a 2-second lag time had more than twice the total errors as those that had a 4-second lag time. He found also that those with a 4-second lag time had twice as many errors as those with a 6-second lag time. So if you can do the math, you can see that errors were doubling with every 2 seconds of decrease in lag time. Dr. Coakley also found that interpreters with a longer lag time produced a greater number of target language sentences that were deemed acceptable. Acceptable here being defined as syntactically correct in the target language. And finally, Dr. Coakley concluded that an increase in lag time enhances the overall comprehension of the source language, as it allows the interpreter more time to process the information coming in before delivering it in the target language. Now, obviously, lag time will differ somewhat significantly depending on the source language, the complexity of it, the pace that it is delivered, the familiarity that the interpreter has with that content. So there are several factors that will impact an interpreter's lag time. So for working interpreters, the complexity of interpreting is pretty overwhelming. Interpreters are engaged in a number of activities all at the same time, as they are processing information, delivering information, receiving information, trying to remember what had been processed and delivered before. It's very complex. Expert interpreters are also self-monitoring for accuracy of their interpretation. It's a lot to be doing at the same time. So this article and research is helpful for those that are actively interpreting to determine what's the best lag time for them. How much lag time should they allow to increase the accuracy of their interpretation? Maybe they should try increasing their lag time slightly to see what kind of effect that has on their interpretation and the accuracy of it. A link to this article is available in the video notes below. I encourage you to read it in its entirety. A lot of great information there. And stay curious, pursue knowledge, and learn something new every day. This has been Josiah Failau with your Research Bite. Thanks for watching.